speak English? If you can answer yes to these questions, great. I think that's wonderful. If you speak both English and Spanish, that means you are a bilingual person. So, congratulations. Now, I have another question. Do you speak Spanglish? This is what I want to talk about today. Spanglish is a very popular trend these past years. Many people like it, many people use it, and I have a particular opinion about Spanglish. And here it is. I'm not a big fan of Spanglish. And it's not that I have anything against people that speak Spanglish, it's just that it's a trap, in my opinion. If you can speak English and you can speak Spanish, that's a wonderful gift, it's a beautiful privilege, but I think when you start mixing them up too often, it can become hard later to stay in one language. You know what I mean? If you are speaking Spanish and you also know English, there might be times where you want to say something, but the particular word in Spanish doesn't come to mind, but the word in English does come to mind first. So you are speaking fast, whatever comes to mind the easiest, that's what you use, and you just throw it out there. And that's good in the matter of communication, because you are able to communicate what you want to say with your words, even if it's just, if it's not in Spanish right then and there, then it's just in another language. And that's, it can be a good thing, I get it. But it can be a trap, because it can make you forget other things from that particular language you are not using. If you always, always speak Spanglish, then it's probable that at some point you will be weak at using both languages. It could happen that you get so used to always mixing up two languages that if you at some point have to use only one, it could be very hard to express some ideas, because you're used to saying them in English and then in Spanish, and to change up both languages, it can be tricky. So think about it. And whenever you have to say something, let's say you're speaking in Spanish, and then an idea in English comes to mind, you want to say it, but you are speaking in Spanish. Try your best to continue in Spanish, to continue in one language, because that exercise is going to be great for your brain. You're going to exercise your brain, and you're going to find out, I'm sure you will, a great way, a perfect way to say it in Spanish. I realize that there are some words and expressions that have no specific substitute in one language and the other. So I know that sometimes it's better to convey a message in one particular language or the other, depending on which language is your first one or your favorite. But do make an effort, because it can be a huge trap that you can fall into. If you fall into the trap of Spanglish, then you can stay only speaking that language, which is not really a language. And when, I'm sure you would say, well, but I can speak Spanglish and most people understand me, or everyone who I talk to speaks Spanglish too, so it's not a problem, so it's great, and I'm a bilingual person and I'm great because I speak Spanglish. And I say, yes, it's amazing that you are bilingual. It's great that you can just get the best of both worlds. You can use whatever you need in any language to convey your messages, to say what you want to say, to express yourself. It is wonderful. But it is even better when you can choose to speak in one language completely, say all your ideas in one language or another. And this is particularly interesting, or let's say, not interesting, but better. Let's say that you're talking to somebody who doesn't speak Spanglish. If you're talking to somebody who only speaks Spanish, for example, it can be rude or uncomfortable for the other person if you all of a sudden throw a word in English or an expression in English. This person, if they don't know English, they could not understand you, or they might feel a little awkward or off because you're saying something that they are expected to understand it, but they can't for whatever reason, and they, you know, you could make somebody else feel uncomfortable, and that's not necessary, because you have the tools in your brain to say whatever you want to say in one language or the other. So please make that effort. That's just my advice, it's my opinion, and I think it's better to have two languages, to have two powerful languages in your brain and in your knowledge, in your life, than a mix-up of two languages. Do you know what I mean? Let's imagine another situation. Let's imagine that you are talking to somebody who speaks Spanish but does not speak English. And Spanish is your native language. But all of a sudden you want to say something in English and that person doesn't speak English. But this person is speaking Spanish as their second language. It's an opportunity for them to practice their Spanish. You could help them, but your help won't be as useful if you are throwing in English words all the time. Okay? It's not a problem if you use it and you also explain to them what they mean, because then it's a learning opportunity, and that's also valuable. That's great if you say, hey, this is how I want to say this, but I want to say it in English because this is how it sounds better for me, and it also, and it means this and that. If you use it like that, then I think that's wonderful. But be careful, because not everyone speaks the two languages that you are using, which are in this case English and Spanish. So be careful there. I know that you might not feel like this, but if you're speaking Spanglish all the time, if you're using Spanish and English together, you might feel that you are bilingual, that you are so strong. Maybe you are. I mean, everyone is different, but it can be very easy to fall into that trap and then to forget how to express some things in one language and the other. So make the exercise and make a switch. It's better to make a switch than always have the two switches on, okay? What do I mean by this? If you're speaking Spanish, have the Spanish switch on and only that one, and then the English one is off. If you're speaking English, then the English switch is on and the Spanish switch is off. Never have the two switches on, because that can just make a mess. It could be difficult for others to understand you, and then you could start forgetting your abilities in one or the other language. So it's always best, in my opinion, to have two strong languages in your brain, and you just choose whichever one you want to use depending on the situation. Okay? Again, I'm not against Spanglish. I use Spanglish sometimes because I use two languages. I speak English and Spanish in my everyday life. So I know how cool it can be, or how easy it is sometimes to say something in a particular language, because there are some ideas that have no translation. It's impossible to translate something. So you want to use them however you are thinking of them, and that's amazing. But there are ways to say your ideas. You're just gonna have to think of other words, other ways in that language, okay? So that's my take on Spanglish. What do you think? Am I being too harsh? Should I be a little more relaxed? I know many people that speak Spanglish all the time, but I just think it can become a weakness. It's not necessarily a weakness in itself, but if you let it, if you start relaxing about it, then it can become a weakness. Just evaluate yourself. If you find yourself using too much Spanglish every day, try to stop and evaluate yourself and say, okay, why am I using that word in English when I know I could say it in Spanish? Or what is the best way for me to express this that I'm thinking in English, but maybe I could say it in Spanish? And the other way around, okay? Maybe this sounds so great in Spanish, but I'm speaking in English right now to an American person. Maybe I could find a way to say it in English, okay? And it's a great exercise for your brain. You're gonna feel smarter the second you do this. Always try to do it like that, okay? And that's it for me.